hit the body of Rust and almost trickled in. Penguins still pressuring. Pettersson couldn't get a grip on that puck, and it's taken away by Florida. Rodriguez was tripped up by Letang, who then smokes Barkov. He's going to draw a crowd. Ekblad and Forsling close in on Letang, and here come all the bodies together. Barkov is still down. Now, he came back in the lineup a couple games ago after missing three in a row. So we'll see here. I think Letang was already the guilty party for the trip on Rodriguez.
He was. And now Rodriguez getting the dirty glove in the face from Jake Guentzel. Don't see that every day. Well, this is going to be interesting how this one plays out for Chris Letang. Barkov, yeah, the original two for the trip, that's an automatic. And you can only wonder if something more is coming for the hit on Barkov, who's still down. And that is a large human on his back.
6-3, 2-15.
Penalty has been assessed. It is now under review.
Oh, boy. So the 5-minute has been assessed for the hit. Nothing mentioned about the trip, the original call. So here's your original call here. It's a trip, no problem.
Yeah.
But then play carries on, and Chris Letang gets tied up with Barkov. This is not a 5-minute major. This is two players coming together. This isn't even a hit. It's almost like their feet came together. I don't think there's any intent by Chris Letang here to do damage to Barkov, but I don't know if Barkov thought the play was over and kind of let up and went backwards and hit his head on the ice, but he is wobbly, and you're right, that's a big man that's gonna need help to get off the ice. We've got 10-12 left in the second period, and he's gonna make his way very gingerly into the locker room. Take a couple more looks here, and here's Letang, just a little bump. That's not much at all. And his feet just got tied up there. This isn't even a penalty.
It's away from the puck. I guess that's the only thing that you look at there, but you're right. It's kind of, yeah. Barkov's just off balance a little.
Yeah,
bit.
Just off balance. It's Letang and Barkov. And again, it's almost like Barkov just came here. The fans are seeing it now here inside the arena. And these are educated fans, man. They know. If they thought it was a 5-minute major, there wouldn't be much going on here. Here we go. Here's the call from Chris Rooney.
After review, 58 Pittsburgh has 2 minutes for tripping and 2 minutes for interference.
Okay. It's tough to really disagree with that. Mike Sullivan's not happy. So let's take a look at both these penalties again. And we'll start with the trip, which is obvious. Chris Letang gets his stick caught up. But then here, Barkov and Letang just, they come together, and it just seemed like Barkov's feet just got tangled underneath him and went down hard.
Osterine with a clear.
Jake Guentzel is fuming right now. He got absolutely abused by Brandon Montour. No call. He went back to the front of the net where he always goes, and he's barking to the ref all the way to the Penguins bench. Montour taking liberties.
Bennett with a cross check to the head of Letang. He's going to go. Nedeljkovic collides with Bennett. Everything's happening here. Extra skater on for the Pens. They're going to get a 5-on-3 when and if Florida touches the puck.
Give him the puck.
Here's Eller. Cross ice, knocked down and catches the glass. Malkin will let Tkachuk get it. He nearly threw a hip into Malkin.
And Tkachuk just tried to take out Evgeny Malkin. Matthew Tkachuk is on full tilt right now.
Yep.
He is looking to take some hides, and the Penguins better have their head on a swivel.
And to that point, Borky, linesman C.J. Murray basically just ushered Tkachuk to the bench and away from this scrum.
C.J. Murray is a local kid. He's from Upper St. Clair.
Let's get the calls here.
Florida penalty number 9, 2 minutes for cross-checking, 2 minutes on sportsmanlike conduct.
Okay,
here we go, baby. Here we go. When opportunity knocks, you better listen. Here's the cross check, broken stick evidence sitting right there.
And that was in response for the hit on Barkov, obviously. Retaliation.
Referees are no dummies. They understand the context of that hit. A lot of chirping going on. And I'm telling you, this started in the first period, and it's just stayed at a nice, not even a simmer, it stayed at a right hot boil. The top hasn't blown off, but it's close.
Feeds Malkin, Bennett's out. Malkin looking, knocked down, right back to him. 5-on-5, Letang shooting, that's blocked, and look out, Lundell, he's got Losterinen with him. He passes to him, and Letang closes the gap and throws Losterinen to the ice.
Now Lundell goes after him, punches Letang. Oh my goodness, sucker punch to the face by Lundell to Letang. Oh man, now the top is off now. All bets are off. A good hit, a great defensive play by Chris Letang, physical on the play. And then Letang, disciplined, stays tight, stays composed, takes a punch in the face from Lundell. Holy moly. There's the hit by Chris Letang, solid physical battle, and then takes a punch in the face, and the Penguins about to go on the power play.